A very good morning, students. Let us begin with the ninth standard science, the last chapter, that is improvement in our food resources. Improvement in food resources. As we all know, without food, no organism can survive. So, which are all called our food items? The food resources, nothing but it may be the cereals, pulses, millets, grams, grains, milk, egg, fish, meat, all together we will call these as the food resources. Now the chapter is improvement in food resources. So we understood which are all our food resources. Now we have to do the improvement. What is the meaning of improvement and why we have to do? Students, as you know, as our population is increasing day by day, everybody requires with the food, right? So we have to increase the food resources, quality and quantity. You can say as the productivity of the food resources, we have to improve. How to improve? What are all the methods we can follow? That all we are going to discuss in the 9th standard chapter, that is improvement in food resources. Yes. Just now I have told you what are all the food resources. I said it is vegetables, fruits, cereals, pulses, millets, grains, everything. So these are all comes under agricultural product. These are all the agricultural product. And I said milk, yolk, fish, meat. Improvement in can do this by selecting the proper quantity or quality of the seeds. They should be disease resistant. The plant should be disease resistant. It should adjust to all the climatic conditions, right? It should be free from the infections. So these are all our desired qualities that we want to improve in the crop yields, right? So first of all, if we want to improve the quantity and quality of the crops, we should understand that few crops can grow in the rainy season and few can grow in the winter season. The crops which can grow in the rainy season are called as kharif season, and the crops are called as kharif crops. Yes, students, the crops which can grow in the rainy season are called as the kharif crops. You know which is the rainy season. It's from June to October. The month from June to October, this is the rainy season where we are getting the kharif crops. Which are all comes under kharif crops? It may be the paddy. Examples like paddy, soybean, right? It may be the soybean, different types of the grains. It may be maize, cotton. So these are all comes under the kharif crops. And some crops can be grown in the winter season. The crops which can be grown in the winter season are called as the rabi crops. So which is the winter season, students? In the winter season they can grow. From which month to which month the winter season is there? Yes, it is from November to April. November to April it is winter season. In the winter season you can grow certain types of the crops, and those crops are called as the rabi crops. And examples for the rabi crops like wheat, peas, mustard, linseed, such type of a crops comes under rabi crops. So we have to see what type of a crop it is, in what season it can be grown. So depending upon that, we can try to improve the crop yields. So to improve crop yields, first you have to see what type of a crop it is, in which season it can be grown very well in everything. Yes, students, the next one is activities for improving crop yields. Now we discussed what are all the crops, what type of the crops can be grown in different seasons and all. Now let us study what we have to do for improving the crop yields. Three activities we have to follow. The first one is crop variety improvement. The second one is crop production improvement. The third one, crop protection management. First you have to think about improving the variety of the crops, then to improve the production, then how to manage the crops. So in these three activities we can improve the crop yields. Let us discuss one by one. Let me begin with the first one, that is crop variety improvement. How can we do the crop variety improvement? It can be done by one of the method called hybridization. What is hybridization? In this we are taking the two plants. Okay, genetically we are modifying these plants. We are changing the genes. For example, let me give the example of A and the B. These are the two plants, A plant and B plant. In B plant, one certain quality is there which we want to improve in A. Okay, so that gene you are extracting from the B plant and introducing it to the A plant. So genes of those plants you are changing. That is called genetically modifying the plants, and that is a type by the method of hybridization, we can improve the crops. The crop yields we can improve, right? So what genes of these plants are changing and preparing? These are called genetically modified plants. Genetically modified plants, these are called. Okay? Yes. In the hybridization, you can follow three methods. One is called intervarietal hybridization, interspecific hybridization, and intergeneric hybridization. Easily you can remember, students, with the names only. Intervarietal, different varieties of the plants you are taking and you are doing the hybridization between them. Okay? Varieties of the plants you are taking, different varieties of the plants, you are doing the hybridization. So that is called as intervarietal hybridization. Then we can do it by taking the plants which belongs to different species. Genus is same, only species is different. That type of the plants we can take and we can do the hybridization. That is called interspecific hybridization. There is one more method that is called intergeneric hybridization. Generic means genus will be different. Two different plants whose genus is different. So such type of a plants you are taking and doing hybridization, that is called intergeneric hybridization. Right, students? So when we want to improve the variety of the crops, we can go through the hybridization. Hybridization you can do by three types, like intervarietal, interspecific, and intergeneric. Right? So by these different types of hybridization, we will improve the crop yields. Right? We understood the hybridization, different types of the hybridization and all. Why we are doing all this? Because we want to improve certain qualities in the crops. What qualities we want to improve in the crops? The qualities are, first one, higher yield. We want to get more and more yield we want, for that we are doing. Improved quality, right? Not only the quantity, we want the quality also, right? Biotic and abiotic resistant. Those crops should be biotic. Biotic means living organisms, insects, pests. It may be some of the rodents, birds will eat the crops, right? So whatever the yeast and all will come, it should be disease resistant. It can stand. So that capacity the plant should have. Abiotic resistance. Abiotic means climatic changes. It may be quite hot, cold. Means how the climate will change, to that the plant should adjust. It may be you are providing sometimes more water, sometimes it will become less. For that also it has to adjust. Like that genetically we are modifying. So called as biotic resistance and abiotic resistance. Change in maturity duration. Maturity duration means the plant, the crops has to grow faster and faster, because we want to again take the second season, again we want to get the yield, right? Because we want to get more and more crops, more and more yield. So the maturity period means growth of the plant, getting the crops, it should be faster. So called change in maturity duration. Next one is wider adaptability. Adaptability means it has to adjust for everything. Like climatic changes, it may be the biotic, abiotic, if it is getting any problem, or it has to adjust to the fertilizers, to the chemicals what we are applying, to everything the crops has to adjust. That is called wider adaptability. Next, desirable agronomic characteristics in the plants. Some plants, if you are taking the examples of the cereals and all, they should grow tall with many branches so that you can get the more yield. There are some of the plants which will be very shorter and growth period will be faster. So like that, what type of the crop it is, it has to adjust and desirable. Desirable means what qualities you are expecting. Like that only we have changed their genes. They have to withstand and we have to get all the benefits called as desirable agronomic characteristics. Right friends, why we are doing all this? Because we want to improve all these qualities in the crops so that we can improve the crop varieties. Right? So this much about the first point, that is crop variety improvement. Right? In the next class, let us study the second point, that is crop production improvement. Okay? Thank you.